Computer, Class 3. Hello children, today we will do Fun with Paint, Chapter 5. In this lesson, you will learn about starting paint, resizing an image, skewing an image, flipping an image, rotating an image, zooming an image, cropping an image, copying and pasting. So let us start. Paint is a simple program for painting on computer. With this program, you can draw and paint new pictures, view and edit the scanned pictures, set your picture as wallpaper. Let us learn more about paint. Starting paint. To start paint, follow the given steps. Step 1. Click on the start button. Step 2. Click all programs. Step 3. Click on accessories. Step 4. Click on paint. Paint window is displayed. Look at the paint window shown below. So children, you have to go step by step to open the paint window and look how this looks like. Let us recall some tools and shapes and their functions. Pencil tool. This tool is used for freehand drawing. Eraser tool. This tool is used to erase, remove the drawings, texts or shapes. Fill with color tool. This tool is used to fill colors in a closed figure. Text tool. This tool is used to write in paint. Brushes tool. This tool is used to draw anything with a free hand movement. The brushes tool has different thickness options. We can change the thickness of the brush. Line shape. This shape is used to draw lines in any direction from top to bottom or from left to right. Rectangle shape. This shape is used to draw squares or rectangles of different sizes. Oval shape. This shape is used to draw ovals or circles of different sizes. A circle is absolutely round, but an oval is egg-shaped. Rounded rectangle shape. This shape is used to draw rectangles or squares with rounded corners. Polygon shape. This shape is used to draw a closed shape with straight lines. Curve shape. This shape is used to draw curved lines. Now children, look at this picture. How it looks like in a computer screen. All these tools and shapes. Children, now we will study about some more features of paint. Resizing an image. Resize is used to change the size of an image by making it shorter or longer. To resize an image, Follow these steps. Step 1. Click on Home tab. Step 2. Click on Select. Step 3. Click on Rectangular Selection and select the image by dragging the mouse over it. You can see here in the picture how to select resize option. Step 4. Click on Resize. Resize and Skew dialog box appears. Now you can see here in the picture, when you click on Resize, you will get this resize box, okay, screen on your computer. Now step 5. Select the Maintain Aspect Ratio checkbox. Now you have to click on the Maintain Aspect Ratio, and in step 6, enter the horizontal value, width or vertical value height. Now you can make the changes in step 6. You can set the horizontal value and set the vertical value accordingly. And in step 7, click OK. So once you click OK, you can see the image which is resized by you. Whatever changes you have made it horizontally, vertically in your picture, you can see that. So that is called resizing your image. Now children, let us learn about skewing an image. By using skew command, the image gets stretched from one end while the other end remains fixed. To skew an image, follow these steps. Step 1, click on Home tab. Step 2, click in Select and then click on Rectangular Selection. Step 3, select the image by dragging the mouse over it. Step 4, click on Resize. Resize and Skew dialog box will appear. Step 5, in the Skew section, enter the value between 0 and 89. Either in the horizontal or vertical boxes. Step 6, click OK. The skew of the image will appear. So children, I hope you understood now how to resize and skew an image. You can see here in the picture, once you skew it, how it looks like. It's a picture of a smiley. First you have selected the front face of this smiley. Once you have skewed this image of smiley, how it looks like vertically or horizontally, whatever changes you have made, so you will see the picture like this. Children, let us learn about flipping an image. Flip command is used to get the mirror image of the drawing either horizontally or vertically. To flip an image, follow these steps. Step 1, click on Home tab. Step 2, click on Select and choose Rectangle Selection. Step 3, select the image by dragging the mouse over it. Step 4, click on Rotate. You will see two options to flip. Step 5, click on Flip Horizontal or Flip Vertical. Now children, here is one example. In this example, the image is flipped vertically. You can see that it is, the image is looking opposite. Okay. Now let us learn about rotating an image. Rotate command is used to change the position of the drawing at different angles. To rotate an image, follow these steps. Step 1. Click on Home tab. Step 2. Click on Select and then click on Rectangular Selection. Step 3. Select the image by dragging the mouse over it. Step 4. Click on Rotate. You will see three options to rotate. Step 5. Click on the rotation direction you want. For example, 90 degree, 180 degree and 270 degree. In this example, the image rotates 90 degree to the right. That means 180 and 270 degree. You can see here, this is the first picture of rotating. This is the straight one. Then once you rotate this straight picture to 90 degree, it looks like this. Then in 180 it looked like this, and in 270 it will look like this. Okay. Now let us learn zooming an image. The zoom command is used to get a bigger and closer view of the image by using zoom in and zoom out features. To zoom the image, follow these steps. Step 1, click on View tab. Step 2, click on the following options. Click on Zoom in to see a closer, and click on Zoom out to reduce the zoom level. You can see here in the picture, when you want to see very close, you can see this picture. It will look bigger also in size. And when you will zoom out, then it will reduce the size of this image or this drawing. Okay. Now let us learn cropping an image. What do you mean by cropping? Cropping means you have cut that, you have selected that part you want to see. Other part is removed. Okay. Step 1. Click on Home tab. Step 2. Click on Select. Step 3. Select the part of the image you want to see. Step 4. Click on Crop. You can see here in this picture, there is an option of cropping the image. Just select that and your picture will be cropped from that part. And you can only see the other part of the image that you want to see. Okay. Now children, let us learn copying and pasting. By using copy and paste command, you can make a duplicate image of the drawing or another place in the drawing area. To copy and paste the image, follow these steps. Step 1, click on Home tab. Step 2, click on Select. Step 3, select the image by dragging the mouse over it. Step 4, click on Copy from the clipboard group. Step 5, click on Paste from the clipboard group. The duplicate image will appear on the top left corner of the drawing area. Step 6. Now place the mouse pointer on the selected image and drag it anywhere in the drawing. As you can see here in this picture, how the picture is dragged with the help of a mouse pointer. Once it is copied, then it is pasted in the other place. Okay. Now let us learn cutting and pasting. By using cut and paste feature is used to delete the image from its original place and paste it to another place. To cut and paste the image, follow these steps. Step 1, click on Home tab. Step 2, click on Select. Step 3, select the image by dragging the mouse over it. Step 4, click on Cut from the clipboard group. The image will disappear from the paint window. Step 5, click on Paste from the clipboard group. The image will appear in the drawing area. You can see here in the picture how the picture is cut from this original picture, how this is cut, and then it is pasted in some other places. You can see here. Now children, you have to learn saving the drawing. You can save your drawing if you wish to see it again or make changes later. To save your drawing, follow these steps. Step 1, click on paint button. Step 2, click on save or save as. The save as dialog box appears. Step 3, type a name for the file in the box. Step 4, click on save. Your drawing gets saved by the name you have typed. You will see that the name of the file appears on the title bar. So this is how you are going to save your drawing. Now children, let us learn how we can open an old drawing. Opening an old drawing. If you want to work on any old drawing that you have saved, the first step will be to open that file. Step 1, click on paint button. Step 2, click open button. Step 3, select the file name that you want to open or type the file name in the file name box. Step 4, click on open button. So this is the way to open an old drawing that you have saved it. Okay. Children, let us learn how to set a drawing as desktop background. You can set your drawing as your desktop background by following the steps given below. Step 1. Click on paint button. Step 2, select set as desktop background from the drop down menu. Step 3, select any of the three options, fill, tile or center. Fill means the drawing fills the entire desktop. Tile means the drawing repeats itself and fills the desktop. Center means the drawing appears in the middle of the screen. So you can see here in the picture. Once you have click on paint button, you will get the option of set as desktop background. After that, you will have some three options like fill, tile and center. So you can select any of the three. Okay. And then you can select the personalize and then you will set your drawing background on the desktop. Okay. Children, I hope you have understood the lesson and you have to practice all the steps on your computer or in your laptop. Now it's time to do some exercises. First question, take the correct option. You have to tick on the correct one. So dash option is used to cut selected part of an image. Crop is the correct one. Tick on that. To get the mirror image of a drawing, we use dash command. Option is flip. So correct option you have to tick it. Then third, dash command gives closer and bigger look of an image. The correct option is zoom. So tick on zoom. Question number two, write true or false. Word is a program used to draw and color images. False. Color palette is present in the view tab. False. Crop is used to get a bigger and closer look of the image. False. Flip feature creates the mirror image of the drawing. True. Copy paste gives the duplicate image of the drawing. True. Question number 3, match the following. Control plus S means saving a drawing. Control plus X means cut a part of a drawing. Control plus C means copy a part of a drawing. Control plus V means paste a part of a drawing. Question number 4. Short answer type questions. What is the use of paint program? for drawing and painting on the computer. Question number 2. Which shape is used to draw a closed shape with straight lines? Polygon shape. What is use of rotate command? To rotate an image in different angles. Long answer type questions. Differentiate between copy paste and cut paste. By using copy and paste command, you can make a duplicate image of the drawing or another place in the drawing area. By using cut and paste feature is used to delete the image from its original place and paste it to another place. Question number 2. Write the steps to. First is resize an image. You have to write the steps. Step 1, click on Home tab. Step 2, click on Select. Step 3, click on Rectangular Selection and select the image by dragging the mouse over it. Step 4, click on Resize. Resize and Skew dialog box appears. Step 5, select the Maintain Aspect Ratio checkbox. Step 6, enter the horizontal value or vertical value. And step 7, click OK. Then B is flip an image. Step 1, click on Home tab. Step 2, click on Select and choose Rectangle Selection. Step 3, select the image by dragging the mouse over it. Step 4, click on Rotate. You will see two options to flip. Step 5, click on Flip Horizontal or Flip Vertical. So children, these are the steps you have to write step by step for both the images. Thank you.